Hey guys, Hanzo here from Devoted Gaming, and this is Bladestorm, The Hundred Years' War.
Hey guys, welcome back to the walkthrough. I'm still in the Battle of Toulouse on the English side. Hopefully, I'm wrapping this battle up. I highly doubt it though, because I still have to take the city and take one more objective afterwards. Things will go smoother if the prince attacks the city, but he instead attacks the other objective, which is further away. The Brahmin's going doing the same thing too. I'll march with them until they go to the other side, I guess. We could use the backup, I suppose. Oh, here comes Edward. Whoa! Edward just wiped out that entire unit by himself. Okay, I was so not needed there. Okay, I think I'm gonna go alone. Okay, that group's mine. Okay, Edward, I call it dibs. I should be okay. Yeah, I'm okay. Ooh, these archers are doing their number on me here. Come on guys, let's go. Oh good, they entered that base. It's not an objective, but that's good news. No, they'll take it. Ooh, javelin guys, come on, I need you. Come with me. These spear guys are probably one of the most strangest units I use because they don't seem like they're very strong, but they are. Their javelin toss ability is probably the best. They can turn disadvantage into advantage. Allow me to demonstrate here. Because I'm pretty sure the top of this hill here is probably a cavalry unit, which is strong against. Ooh, these ones gone, perfect. As I say, there's probably a cavalry unit at the top of the hill, which is strong against spear guys, but javelin alone, even without Mighty Arm, can do a lot of damage, but I'm gonna use Mighty Arm just to be safe. Mighty Arm and javelin is a guaranteed kill on anything. Let's see if I'm right. There's advantage. See? I'm gonna take the commander out too. Good. No, lucky. And javelin throw, I'm gonna miss him probably. Oh no, he's run through. Overpowered. Alright. I wasn't expecting me to take the city so easily, actually. Oh well. Maybe I can wrap this battle up in one more video here. There's only one more objective and the prince is already near it. And the base points are gone too, so yeah, I'm ending this. As long as Duke Clan won't get in the way, but I don't see him on the battlefield yet. Or did he lose already? That's a count of whatever, I'm not gonna pronounce that. Armagnac. And he's running towards a mountainside. I guess this count's not very smart. I guess I have to give up. Where are you going? Stay in the start. Continue facing the mountainside. Seems I was overmatched. Yes, you were outmatched by a mountainside.
Curse it! We are late. Regardless, that woman has quite some talent.
Duke Clank went the other direction. Okay, he's not very smart. Cause I'm able to take this base and it's over. I don't need your help, Ron, I got this. Ooh, fencers. And over? There we go. I think there's a cutscene. Or maybe after when I leave.
you possess considerable skill with that bow. Will you take service with me?
Truthfully, I aspired to your service formerly, but was turned away without an audience. They saw merely my countenance, not my ability.
An ignominy which someday I shall redress. I, Edward, Prince of Wales, do offer you a place. Mistress of the bow, what say you?
So it's safe to assume she's not a mercenary anymore. And we also learn a lesson. You never judge someone just solely on their looks. But she does suck as a bow, with the bow, because I did all the work. Oh, there's gossip here. I don't think it's anything important.
Those rumors, you recall, the ones concerning Deray and Laia.
You mean the ones about them joining forces?
Indeed, I understand the pair of them are involved in something down in Gascony. I gather that Deray is mostly milling around conversing with people.
Undoubtedly, he will wait for that ear to accomplish something, then attempt to steal the praise for it.
Okay, that was stupid. We already know that. Alright, thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.